Good afternoon, my friends. Took a bus into Lancaster, Pennsylvania. One of my favorite trips. I could drive out here, but I prefer the bus. Besides, it's too many tolls. It's something like a 4-hour drive, so I take the bus. You relax. You're not hurried, you know? No traffic, let somebody else deal with the traffic. Anyway, gonna look around for a bit. This farm, it's a working farm. Quite a large farm. I'll let you see for yourself, my friend. A lot of open space here. Most of the open space that you see is owned already. Big farms. So see, like one straight ahead, as you saw before. Well, I got a video, which you see later on. Here, there's no electricity. They're not plugged to the grid, electrical grid. They have their own way of lighting the land. You see, there's a family. They ride these standing up. You seldom see bikes that you pedal. It's for the youngsters. This is a basic form. Comfortable, very comfortable. This is a family home here. Beautiful little place with the flowers. And here, this way you go in and you buy some souvenirs, whatever you need. They got bird things there. I forgot their name. Anyway, it's where they come and drink their water and get their food. All handmade stuff. All handmade. I won't take the camera inside. I don't want to do that. They don't like to be photographed. And I don't want to disrespect. I don't want to disrespect them. We go back this way. Just walk around a bit. The Amish themselves don't ride. They don't have vehicles. Well, some have adapted to the 21st century, but the real true Amish person would not buy a car or a truck. They prefer the horse and buggy. There's reasons for that. They feel that if you get into that kind of way of living, you become lazy, and you do not adhere to the the tradition. This is a typical mode of transportation, beautifully crafted. Very nice. Inside. Is the bird feeders that I couldn't remember the name of before. Oh, this is handmade, by the way. All handmade and decorated. And of course, you know, they make their living and they feed their family, of course, with what would they grow and they what they sell. But they also have the ladies of the house sell their own little things, and of course make money and keep producing to keep the family well off. Or they also believe in home schooling. They do not send their kids to schools. They are home taught, and they go to about the 8th grade, and then it's Amish living. Expect that. This is their way. They must be respected. Entrance, we just pulled in. Beautiful. This hi there. How are you? The puppies? Hi. Can I pet you? Oh. How are you, huh? I don't know if he wanted me to stop, or he was trying to tell me something. The little guys here, look at this. The horses, got horses back there. Got little puppies here. Look how cute they are. Hi, guys. Hi. Cutie pies. That's right. Uh-oh, got a dog here. And he's a watchdog. There he is right there. He walks around and just keeps guard.
Susan Real.
Oh, this our guy?
Hola. Mi amo Daniel. Bienvenido, Pennsylvania.
He's from Pennsylvania.
Si.
Yes. You're also a teacher, you say, right?
Si, I'm a teacher and
he's not Amish. Not Amish, but he does tours and he narrates. He was narrating before. About here later on. Yeah, some other farms. Well, you see the missile, like those are silos for rice or is it corn? I'm not sure which. It's a very popular farm to come to and see, visit it. Come around, you walk and take in the views and the good karma, the beautiful scenery. This is the family homestead right here. Also, I won't get no closer because, like I said, I respect them and I don't want to intrude. They're very private people. And if you're gonna take a picture, please ask them first. Take it upon yourself to take their photo. Well, I have taken photos, but I've done it from far and private and candidly. If you want a photo, like I said, you ask for permission. Especially of the children. Okay, so basically, this is the homestead of the family. And this guy here is tired. He's gonna relax, take it easy for a while. Thank you guys. You have been